not only to us, but to everyone here.
I think that making sure that girls are aware of green issues is really important for their future. All of the values that surround sustainability are really important for girls to understand for their future lives, because if these issues aren't addressed, then they're going to have a really difficult future. So I think by addressing those issues now in the curriculum and in different areas of the curriculum as well, then people realise that it's not just about green issues, actually it's about life and the values spread right the way through.
It's a magic.
It's not that easy being green, having to spend each day the color of the leaves, when I think it could be nicer being red or yellow or gold or something much more colorful like that. It's not that easy being green. Seems you blend in with so many other ordinary things, and people tend to pass you over 'cause you're not standing out like flashy sparkles in the water or stars in the sky. But green's the color of spring, and green can be cool and friendly like, and green can be big like an ocean, or important like a mountain, or tall like a tree.
Well, it's difficult with some items, things like the dry foods, because we have to get those off big suppliers, and obviously they're going to come from wherever. What we try to do is with fresh food, such as meat, we purchase from the butcher in Bruton, who gets a large percentage of his meats from local farms. We buy eggs from Black Egg Farm, which is probably about 8 miles from here. We buy milk and cheese from Longman's Dairy, and yogurts come from a company in Devon. So that's sort of where we try and keep the food miles down.
When you first have a group of children, the very tiny children, we're teaching them to be safe outside, and we're teaching them how to play with sticks safely. Mm-hmm. We're teaching them to respect the world around them, so we're teaching them to be kind and gentle to animals and the plants that are around us.
So once they get to year 5 and 6, the girls in those year groups spend an afternoon a week down in the nature reserve, and they're following the John Muir Award scheme. And the emphasis with John Muir is very much on ecology and conservation. But again, very much like Forest School, it's about the process, it's about having respect for the environment.
I love the cutting because you can do loads of things there. And last year we made houses like for bats and birds, and it was really fun making. When I went to the cutting the first time, I was really scared because I didn't really like nature, but then I now love it so much. When she was just a girl,
she expected Conservation is important because all the marine life are dying, like fish, turtles, axolotls and dolphins, because all the people have been throwing plastic bottles and plastic bags into the sea, so it causes pollution.
Some tutor times they head down and they take the big recycling bins and they empty it into the recycling centre, and then the waste gets like put into a big machine where it's compressed and sent off to the company.
Our school has a great amount of experience and knowledge in sustainability and how to work towards a sustainable society. And being an eco school would help us, and does help us, to express that to others and to lead by example in developing a more ecologically friendly world.
Being an eco school already means that we've done this quite a bit at the moment, and we'd like to keep it so that we can keep doing this and spread it further and wider as hard as we can.
Inviting other schools to come and join our eco meets. We had the idea, didn't we, of bringing up the other schools in Bruton, and we could talk about the things that we do, spread our ideas with them. We also invite prep schools quite regularly to come and see what we do here as well, which is really important because, as we mentioned in our essay, we think the younger children are the ones that can make a really big difference. But I think generally you guys just want to lead by example.
Use it up, wear it out, make it do or do without.
Our green motto encapsulates the spirit of Sunny Hill, and situated in the heart of Somerset, it's difficult to want anything other than to preserve our environment.
It's safe to say that Sunny Hill has always had a green ethos, but in recent years this has become a fundamental part of our character.
Ultimately, a school, and particularly a boarding school, is responsible for preparing individuals for the rest of their lives. And the green values instilled into the girls at Sunny Hill will certainly stay with them for years to come. At Sunny Hill, being green is not only encouraged, but expected. And it's at the heart of all that we do.
Sunny Hill is unique in the sense that an idea, no matter how extraordinary, can always become some form of reality. This is made possible by communication, energetic cooperation, and an abundance of ideas.
To regain the Eco Ambassador status would be to further strengthen our influence and accelerate us in achieving our ambitions. We believe that in a world where swift action is necessary, our drive and passion for the environment enables us to be in the right place to make ideas happen.